Glory to God. Jesus said, no man.
No man.
Pluck you from the Father's hand.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we're safe. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Safe. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Welcome everybody. Glory to God to another Sunday morning service. Glory to God. I'm charged, fired up, encouraged. Glory to God. God is good.
Yes, He is.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say with me, say it's working out.
It's working out.
Hallelujah.
It's working out.
It's working
glory
out.
To God. If you stick with it, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
It will work out.
Yes.
God will bring you to an expected end.
Yes.
Glory to God. It'll give you a bright future and a good hope.
Yes.
Any moment, glory to God, with God can be a moment when the whole story changes.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. I'm talking about just right in any minute. He can change it. It don't take him 20 years to change something. My God, you exercise your faith and put it forth. Glory to God with some thanksgiving to him. You must come with thanksgiving. How many of you know that?
Hallelujah.
We are a church, glory to God, of thanksgiving.
Hallelujah.
And a church of giving God glory.
Hallelujah.
Why? Because we believe God's word. Hallelujah. And because we believe God's word, we tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Isn't that right?
Thank you.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
Oh my God. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God. Hallelujah is present
hallelujah.
Here.
Hallelujah.
Today, glory to God. This is a day, glory to God, you can give whatever you want. Glory to God, don't go back empty, amen. Amen, glory to God. I won't leave you like I came in Jesus' name. Remember that song? That's an old song. I won't leave here like I came in Jesus' name. You see, every time you come, glory to God, you're investing in your destiny. Glory to God, and you making your walk with God stronger as you give him thanks and as you take in his word. Glory to God. Transformation comes by what? The renewing of the mind. Glory to God. Brother Stephen, come on. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Brother Stephen's going to lead us today. Glory to God and giving God thanks. And
hallelujah.
Return the glory unto him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Anybody excited?
Amen.
Did y'all like that song, Saving His Own?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. How about chosen to do a work for the master?
Amen.
Call that. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Pastor.
Glory to God.
As the word says, come into his house with thanksgiving. And we coming into his house today in unison to come in front of the altar to give our Lord, our God, our Savior thanksgiving. We come to his altar. Please come to the front of the house. Lift your arms in praise because we come today to give thanks to our Lord, our God, our Savior. Oh, hallelujah. We praise you today, our God. We come to return the glory, the honor to you, our God. Hallelujah. We thank you today, our God. We come to give you thanks, to restore the glory, the honor to you. Hallelujah. We praise you today, our God. We restore you today, our God. We come in thanksgiving. Our heart, our joy, are restoring to you. We come with thanks. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. We flourish because of you. We have honor and praise and flourish because of you. We have a flourishing life. Hallelujah. We profit because of you. We have joy because of you. We have rest because of you. Hallelujah. 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 We return the glory to you, my God. Hallelujah. We come to you today in praise. This is your house, Father. We're building it on a strong foundation to you, Father. Your word today, Father, it lives in us. We come to you, Father, in praise today, Father. We come with testimony today, Father. Hallelujah. You live in us. You breathe in us, Father. That living water flows in us today, Father. We say thank you today. We say thank you today, my God. We praise you. We honor you. You are glorious. You live in us today, Father. Hallelujah. We bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Rejoice in you, Father. Our heart rejoices. Our spirit rejoices. Hallelujah. 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 Your spirit lives in us, Father. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the Lord, our Savior King. He gave our life. Hallelujah. His blood cleanses us. Today, it's as fresh today as the day it flows. Oh, glory to you, my God. Hallelujah. It's in us, Father. Forgiveness. Oh, glory to you, Father. Hallelujah. Your spirit, it flows in us, Father. Hallelujah. We give you thanks today, Father. Hallelujah. Our children will prosper today, Father. They will be kings and priests. They are our future leaders today. They are our future presidents today. They are our future representatives, our judges, our teachers, our scientists. Oh, glory to you, my God. The future is unlimited. Hallelujah. We return the glory to you, my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We proclaim you to be our God. We are not ashamed. We give you thanks. We come to you in thanksgiving. Hallelujah. We flourish today because of you, my God. We have victory today because of you. The devil must flee. You gave us the power. It lives in us, and we give you the victory. We return the glory to you, Father. We go from glory to glory to glory because of you, and we give you thanks. We are at your altar today, Father, as your word commands, and we are giving you thanks. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praising you today, my God. That rest that only you can provide. That flourishing that only you can provide. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We rejoice today, Father. We have that peace today, Father. You surround us today as a shield. Your word, the same today, tomorrow, to the end of time. It will never change. And we rejoice in it today, Father. We have that peace today, Father. We have that strength today, Father, because of you. We have thanksgiving today, Father. We have joy today. We have peace today, Father, that you give us, Father. It lives in us, Father. It lives in us today, Father, and we have thanks. And we declare today, Father, we come with humble hearts, Father. Oh, glory to you, my Lord, my Savior. You redeemed us. Oh, we have a seat at the table in the heavenly places because of you. Oh, my heart rejoices. My soul rejoices. Oh, glory to you, my God. I got up this morning giving you thanks. I had rest tonight, last night, unlike I have ever known because of your peace. Oh, glory to you, my God. And I am here at your altar giving you thanks. Oh, glory to you. I restore to you today, and I give you thanks. I give you thanks. I give you thanks, and I give you praise, and I return the glory to you, my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here your people are, Father. Here they are in your house, built on a strong foundation, praising you, giving you glory, restoring it to you, Father. Hallelujah. We praise you, Father. We return and give you thanks and glory and honor to you, my God. Hallelujah. 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 Here we are, Father, standing on your word, glorifying you, Father, praising you and returning honor to you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. 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 You are great. You're great to be praised. Your thoughts are not. Our thoughts are greater or stronger. Oh, glory to you. We turn to you, our God. We keep our eyes on you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You said we would not have troubles. No, you did, but you said you would be with us and guide us through this. You said that you would not give us anything that we could not withstand. Oh, glory to you. We give you thanks. We give you honor. We give you praise. Oh, glory to you, my God. I give you thanks. And his people say thank you. Say thank you, Father. We say thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Returning the glory. Returning the honor. Returning the praise to you, Father. And his people said thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Amen. And amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Let the church say amen. Can we say glory? Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated if you can. Glory to God. Thank you, Brother Stephen. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to get Brother Bailey more up here. Glory to God to give thanks and return the glory to God. He's going to get it. He's going to get him a Sunday. Amen. Don't y'all think Brother Baymore will get a Sunday?
Oh, yes.
Huh?
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to pray at this time for Miss Proverbia Kelly.
Proverbia.
Huh?
Proverbia.
Proverbia? Amen. Glory to God. You're her son, right? Grandson, won't you come up? I want you to stand in proxy for her. Amen. How many people know what standing in proxy for somebody is? Huh? That's like she's here. Glory to God, but he's standing for her. Amen. And we're going to pray right now. I want hands, glory to God, extended and extend them in faith. Glory to God. We believe in God for a miracle for your grandmother on today. Amen. Hallelujah. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Father, we come in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. We thank you, Father God, and give you praise that at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God. And so, Father, we pray, hallelujah, for Miss Proverta. Glory to God, in the name of Jesus, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet right now, in the name of Jesus, we release your healing virtue and your healing power. And we command in the name of Jesus, every sickness, every disease, and every infirmity to desist now in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. We speak miracle power, working power over her life right now, over her body in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we command you to be healed in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. And Father God, this is the confidence that we have in you. That if we ask anything according to your will, you hear us. And we know when you hear us, we have the petitions that we desire from you. And Father God, we speak it now. We speak it now. We speak it now. Healing is heard from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. We decree it and it is established. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Come on, let's give him thanks. Amen. Let's give him thanks. Let's give him thanks. Amen. Glory to God because he heard us. Amen. God bless you, my brother. Amen. Hallelujah. We're moving in faith. Amen. We live in faith. Hallelujah. How many of you know that?
Thank you today.
We live in faith.
Hallelujah. Yes.
It's the only way.
Yes.
It's the only way. What you see, glory to God, what you see going on, it's all done by faith.
Amen.
Are you here?
I praise you. I praise you. I praise you.
Glory to God.
Glory to you, my God.
Hallelujah. I showed some people a model of our new church building.
Hallelujah.
It's done by faith, friends.
I'm telling
you right now, it's done by faith. And if you think it can't happen right then, hallelujah, right in this time, a man went to a church, glory to God, and gave him $5 million to build a church. Can you imagine what kind of church you could build for $5
million?
Here is $5 million. Build a church. Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Hallelujah. When Jesus had to take a trip to Egypt, God sent them wise men with frankincense, myrrh, and gold. Yes. What was it? Frankincense, myrrh, and gold. All of that's expensive stuff. He said, listen, they're going to be hunting you to kill you. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to finance your trip to Egypt. So that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of by the prophet. Out of Egypt have I called my son. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Y'all ever read that scripture? Out of Egypt have I called my son. Let's go to, again, welcome everybody. And I'm excited.
Amen.
Today, glory to God. You came today, so you get your scripture, okay? We've given them out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm going to give Sister Stephanie two, so she can, when she sees Sister Yolanda tomorrow, say, here's your scripture. Amen. Here you go. Amen. Jeremiah 29 and verse 11.
Amen.
Is that all right?
Amen.
29. In verse 11. Can y'all tell in the spirit that something's going on in the church?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
If God is moving.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's moving. He's moving. He's moving. Glory to God. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said who?
The Lord.
Now what else do you care? Once you know what God is thinking about you. They can call you anything they want.
Exactly.
But he said, this is what I think about you. Are y'all hearing me?
Amen. Amen.
You know the brain and the mind, and glory to God, this is where agendas are developed in the mind. And people have been influenced by all kinds of different things in their brain and in their mind, glory to God. But God says, I want you, glory to God, to know what I'm thinking. How many want to know what the Lord is thinking?
Amen.
Huh? What the Lord thinking about you, right?
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're going to have some fun with this. Amen. Because we're going to find out what God think about us.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you are captured and take it when you know what God thinks about
Amen.
You?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Will you own it for your own? Glory to God. Or will you look around at situation and circumstance? How you doing? I'm doing good under the circumstance. Well, what you doing under that? Who told you to be under a circumstance? I know the thoughts I think toward you, said the Lord. What kind of thoughts are they? They thoughts of peace. And not of evil, to give you an expected end. Somebody should have an amplified Bible to help me out here. Glory be to God. Who has an amplified Bible? Or can we just put the amplified up here? When you have Sister Monica, you can get just about anything done. I can get amplified up here.
Right now.
What y'all say?
Amen.
Amen. 29:11 from the amplified. Hallelujah. For I know the plans and thoughts that I have for you, says the Lord. I got a plan for you. I got a plan for you, and I know what it is. Glory to God. He know what it is already. He said, Jeremiah, before you entered into your mother's womb, I knew you.
Yes.
And I ordained you.
Yes.
Now, who want to walk all the way through their life and get down there with God and say, I know your plan is over here for me, but I ain't did none of your plan. I did my own plan. Glory to God, I let people tell me what to think. I was influenced by the world. I was influenced by ideas. See, the flesh is a body of ideas that are contrary to what God thinks. See, when John saw Jesus coming, he said, behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Glory to God. When you look at that word sin there, it's not like some of the other words that's used for sin. That word sin there has to do with a system. He has come to reset the system. Anybody here breathing?
Amen.
From rebellion over to walking a life with God. And I'm not talking about being religious or anything. I'm just talking about having a relationship with God. Hallelujah, basing this on the one who got a plan for it. How many know God's plan better than our plan?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, amen.
It's better than that. I'm telling you right now, God's plan is better than our plan. Yes. Glory to God. Because his plan got peace too. Mm-hmm.
And well-being.
And not for disaster. Amen. Yeah. To give you a future and a hope. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. I know a lady named Future May. Glory to God. That's what they named. Future May. Future and a good hope.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Now, let's go over because here's his thoughts now. Okay. How many say his thoughts as well?
Greater than our thoughts.
Peace. And not evil. His thoughts is well-being.
And not disaster.
You can't get what you get from God, you can't get any place else.
Amen.
120 years, to live 120 years is God's plan for everybody in this room. To live 120 years. 120 years. Well, what about David? Well, David said 70 years. And how long did he live? 70 years old. He went on out of here. Glory to God. Moses said 120. How long did Moses live? It was a system of belief. Moses believed for 120. David believed for 70. They both got what they believed for. Glory to God. But it was God's will before David came that man should live 120 years. Amen. Moses was 120, say his eyes wasn't dim, neither had his strength abated. Isn't that one?
Yes. Amen.
Where else can you get that at? People say, I don't want to live that long. Well, you can live that long and be in health if you do it with God and according to God's plan.
Amen.
Amen. It will add years onto your life. With long life will I satisfy you and show you my salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. With long life. This is where you get it. You get it from God and from the plan of God. Now you have the Word Bible, right?
Yeah.
Okay, look in the Word and let's go over to John 1 and 12, and then I'm going to start giving out some scripture. We'll be out of here. We'll be out of here. We'll be out of here in a little bit. All right? Everybody comfortable?
Amen.
You cold, hot? Glory to God. Hallelujah. John 1 and verse 12. We're going to read it from the King James Version. But as many as received him. Do we have anybody here that has received him?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Everybody in this room, glory to God, that has received him. He's talking about Jesus.
Amen.
As many as received him, to them gave he power to do what?
Become the sons of God.
Even to them that believe on his name. Are y'all here breathing? Now watch this, because just read it from the Word, all of the translations.
All of it from 12?
Yes.
All right. But to all who believe on him, did receive him, but to those who did accept him.
So receiving him is accept accepting him. I'm talking about accepting him. Amen. 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 How many people know that there's a lot of talk about being accepted?
Amen. Amen.
Yeah, people want to be accepted. They say, hey man, you can wear a blue bandana if you just go shoot that block up right there. And here's your bandana when you get back. And the guy, boom, 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 and he go dump on a whole block just to get a blue bandana. Because he want to be accepted by those who got the blue bandana. Are y'all here?
Amen.
You know, there comes a time in your life, glory to God, where it's not so much about you getting accepted, but about Jesus getting accepted.
Amen.
Us accepting him and accepting not just I'm on my way to heaven, but man, listen, I accept him to do all of the things that he promised to do in his word. I accept him as the author and the finisher of my faith. I accept him, hallelujah, as Lord and Master and Savior. I accept him as the people accepted him who said, never a man spake like this man. I accept his word over anything else. I don't care what happened. Got this him. I'm feeling this him. Well, you gonna accept this him over what Jesus said? No, his word has preeminent. Mary said at the wedding of Cana, she said, whatever he tell you to do, do it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Anybody here agree?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, keep reading now. Okay. Are you not through? Accept him.
Who welcomed him.
Who welcomed him. Is he welcome?
Amen.
Okay.
Yet to as many as took him.
Took him.
Welcomed
him. Accepted him.
Yes.
What happened to him?
The right to become children of God.
The right to become. Everybody say rights.
The rights.
Everybody fight for rights, right?
Amen. Authority.
Civil rights. Human rights. Gay rights. All kind of rights. But he gave us the right to become a son of God.
Hallelujah.
Keep going.
Authority.
The right, the authority, and what?
The privilege of becoming.
Woo, Lord, what a privilege, huh? Fellowship with Jesus. Friendship with Jesus. Fellowship divine. Glory to God. How he gave us the authority to become. The authority to become. But now, here is what he's writing to us. So that we can see it, so that we can believe it, so that we can become it. You're just going to become. No, you're going to run into something. You don't know where you're going. Glory to God. But if he set it there for you to end up there, you will know what his plan is. You can see it, you can believe it, and you can become it.
Hallelujah.
Everybody say become it.
Become it.
Become it.
Become it.
Though he was rich, yet for our sake he became poor, so that we through his poverty might be made rich. Why do you think he's telling us that? So we can see it, believe it, and become rich.
Amen.
Think we can build a beautiful, glory to God, place to worship God if we're rich? Just think of it. Everybody left on the 23rd, came back on the 30th rich.
Hallelujah.
Huh? Amen.
Now who won't be resisting being rich? We watch it on the TV how I'm living, the lifestyle of the rich and the famous. Glory to God. Some of us know that better than we know what Jesus said. What was in the magazine? Who got what kind of car? And who lived in what kind of house? And what Nene and them doing? And all of that. Nene and them got a bad house. Right? And all of this stuff. Church folks now. But if we accept him, receive him, he's going to give us the right and the privilege to become sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. You ain't got to stay who you are, or who you think you are, or who they told you you are. You can go right here to the Lord Jesus Christ through the Spirit of the living God. And when you do it, glory to God, there is power to become what God said you are in his word. Okay, thank you so much for that. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 9. Y'all ready for a scripture?
Yes.
I'm doing good. I got a little time. But as it is written, I have not seen. Okay? So my eye ain't seen. We get it? My eye has not seen this yet. So he got the plan, right? So we can't go to him with the plan. I'm going to take God the plan, and he going to go along with it. He won't. Glory to God. You go to him and find the plan. Glory to God. And when you find the plan, I guarantee you, every single thing that you need to fulfill that plan will be given to you. Glory to God. Even if he had to put a dog, if he had to fill a dog mouth full of money and bring them right to that door for you with the money in his mouth. Ooh. Yeah, I don't believe it, but that dog crying out there, the dog got a big old pile of money in his mouth. Glory to God. God, glory to God. Hallelujah. He'll do it. Glory to God. Abraham, what you see over there? Oh, it's a ram in the bush. Okay, I got one. Abraham named the place Jehovah Jireh, for he said, this is the place where the Lord sees. Glory to God. And when he sees, glory to God, he meets it. So our eyes have not seen it, nor our ear heard it. 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 9. Our ear has heard it. Something mighty sweet about the Lord. Something mighty sweet about the Lord. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard. Something mighty sweet about the Lord. Ain't that a good song? Huh? Y'all remember that song? Y'all remember that song? Sister Mitchell remember that song? Something when we used to dance on us. Something mighty sweet about the Lord. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard. Hallelujah. Neither have it entered into the hearts of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. How many of you love him?
Yes.
Okay? He got some stuff prepared for them that love him. But God has done what?
Revealed him.
Oh, so they got to be come by revelation. Them under us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of man, save the Spirit of man, which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. Okay, keep going. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we... So when we were clapping, thank you, Jesus, 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 and then we start speaking in another tongue. We receive the Holy Ghost. And we receive the Holy Ghost so that the Holy Ghost could show us the things that are freely given to us of God. It wasn't for goofing and swinging from chandelier. That's cool too, you know. Glory to God, you get your little dance in. Glory to God, you praise God, and you snot, and you cry, and you purge, and you do all that thing. But once you finish snotting and crying and purging, glory to God, the Holy Ghost came to show us the things that are freely given to us of God.
Yes.
So you mean there must be some things that are freely given to us of God, or what the Holy Ghost coming to show us? Take the Holy Ghost that's in you and start from this day depending on him to show you the things that are freely given to you by God. I know you're going to show me the things that are freely given to me of God. Okay? And so to me, so you're going to take Romans 1 and verse 6. Brother Bazemore, you have Romans 1 and 7. Brother Fitzroy, you have Romans 3 and 24. Sister Tanya, you have Romans 4 and 16. Sister Stephanie, you have Romans 4 and 25. And then take Romans 5, 1 and 2. Tell Yolanda, you picked that scripture up for today, okay? Amen. That's all in love, my friends. Amen. Brother Marvin, glory to God. Romans 5 and verse 9. Sister Mitchell, Romans 5 and verse 11. My brother, what's your name?
Douglas.
Okay. Brother Douglas, you gonna take Romans 5 and 17. And my sister, what's your name?
Maria.
Okay, you're gonna take 5 and 19. Glory to God. Who's next? Young brother, you can read? Yeah, you can read. What grade you in? Third. Oh, you can read, man. I know you can read. Glory to God. My second grade teacher taught me how to read. Glory to God. You're gonna have Romans 6 and verse 2. Amen. My sister, what's your name?
Malia.
And your name is? James?
Jamion,
okay. Jamion, Malia. Did I give you a scripture, Malia? I'm going to give you one right now. Jamion, you got Romans 6 and 2, right? Malia, you're going to have Romans 6, verse 6 and 7. My brother, what's your name? What it?
Diavion.
You're going to have Romans, I said 6 and 7. You're going to have Romans 6 and 11. Amen. Sister Kimmy, you're going to have Romans 6 and 14. Brother Dixon, you got Romans 6 and 18. Sister Monica got Romans 6 and 22. And Brother Steve got Romans 7 and verse 4. Amen. Amen. Let's get it going. Amen. 1 and 6. Romans 1 and 6. The Holy Ghost was using Paul to show us the things that are freely given to us by God. Y'all ready for it?
Amen.
Glory to God.
Romans 1 and 6. Uh-huh. Among whom are ye also the called of Jesus Christ.
Huh? The call of Jesus Christ. How many called people here?
Amen.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost, through Paul, said that everybody in here is called. By whom, among whom, are ye also the called of Jesus Christ? Say it again.
We are the called.
Okay, lead us in that, Sister Mitchell. All right, we are the called. Amen. Can you say it?
We are the called.
Amen. We are the called. He said it right there. We are the called. I'm called. Glory to God. Called to what? The marriage feast of the Lamb. We are called to the kingdom of God. We are called to righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. We are called to healing. We are called, glory to God, to everything. Glory to God, that reverses that curse that came through Adam. The system has been reset. And now we call to this new system that's been reset. King James, Romans 1 and 7. Who got that? Brother Bazemore? Okay. 1
and 7.
1 and 7. Yes, sir. That's okay.
Therefore, for it is a faith that it might be by grace
many know that the Holy Ghost is called the Spirit of grace?
Amen.
Do you know that grace is not just undeserved kindness and unmerited favor? It's also enabling power. Say it with me. Say grace.
Grace
is God's power.
Is God's power
coming upon me?
Coming upon me.
And causing me.
And causing me
to be.
To be
what I could never be.
What I could never be.
And to do.
And to do
what I could never do.
What I could never do. Get in me.
That's it, right?
Live
there.
In me.
And so when we come with faith, grace or enabling power is released.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I know, we got it all figured out. We're going to analyze it. Glory to God. We're going to try to work it out. We're going to try to figure it out from our own human mind. No, I believe it, glory to God. And because I believe it, he gave me unmerited favor, undeserved kindness, and enabling power to become it and to do it, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Abraham said, no hope, no hope for no 100-year-old man having no baby and no 90-year-old woman having no baby. He said, ain't no hope, but I'm a hope anyway.
Yeah.
I'm hoping anyway. I consider not nothing. Nothing. I went to a building, right? It was the building, 12 classrooms downstairs, and 3 locks. And so I get in the place. The place been shut up for a long time. Glory to God. It's dirty inside that building. And so I had dressed up because I'm meeting with these people, right? And the Lord said, If you bow down and worship me, I'll give you this building and I'll give you all of those things. When I got up from worship, you know how much I told those board members, Brother Bazemore, I'd give them for that building? I told them I'd give them $25,000 for that building and all the lots, everything. They looked in there like, this preacher, something wrong with him. But they went and whispered over there, and they came back, and the board president put his hand out to shake it. It's a deal. The first church building I bought was with a church, sanctuary, parsonage, fellowship hall, and a huge yard. Do you know how much I paid for it? $7,500. Are y'all here with me? You can't analyze what God gonna do. You can't figure it out, glory to God. You can't keep dialing into your bank account talking about I'm living by faith.
Hello.
Are y'all hear me? Let me see how much I got. It ain't never got nothing to do with what you have. It has to do with this right here. This and this. And the reason why he set it up like this is so anybody could get it. Anybody. Any one of them children on the row right there can believe God. And grace will be released for you to do what it is that you want to do. Are y'all breathing?
Amen.
There ain't nothing stopping. There ain't nothing stopping you from going to Stanford. Glory to God.
Hell.
Not a thing in this world. Glory to God. I believe God. I believe in right now. Glory to God that's where I'm going. Are y'all hearing me? It ain't either. Like somebody that walk on water or something. No, no. It don't get it. Well, he walks on water. Glory to God. He can get it. No, it's for everybody. And that's why he set it up that way. Therefore, it is a faith that it might be by grace to the end, that the promise might be sure to. How many of the seed?
All.
How many of the seed in him?
All the seed.
Everybody in here, right?
Right.
That the promise might be sure, not with vacillating and staggering like we're drunk. No! The promise is sure to all the seed. All of it. Glory to God. All of it. Not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. Can I get a strong amen here? Glory to God.
Glory to God.
I'm preaching myself happy. Glory to God. I don't know if y'all getting this or not. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But I just gave you train fare home. Amen. Glory to God. Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Amen.
I'm talking about the nugget about what God thinks. He said, I want this thing to be so sure. I want it to be sure for Kimmy. I want it to be sure for everybody in this room. Glory to God. And so I put it so you can believe it. You can believe. Let me tell you something. You can believe.
Every fiber of your being.
Huh? The man said, what are you doing out here on this lot? I said, I'm cleaning my car. What you think? He said, you ain't even made no deal for the car. I'm cleaning it off. That's my car. He said, what? That's my car right there. I'm cleaning it off. It's mine. He looked at me upside my head like I had lost my mind. But he wasn't looking upside my head when I came back and paid him cash for it the next week.
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me? I'm telling you right now, glory to God, you go and speak, glory to God. They say, what are you buying today? Nothing, I'm just setting some stuff aside. I'll be back for it.
They said, what?
I said, yeah. I said, I got to Las Vegas 20 years ago, and I was buying secondhand suits for $25. Get them all to the fixed up, you know, so you could dress up, $25, and then they go up to $100, $150 suit, to a $300 suit. These all were $900, they was $895 a piece. I'm going up to that level.
Amen.
I ain't staying down on this level. This ain't it, glory. This is not it. This is not the thought that God thinks toward me. I'm telling you right now, I'll take a forceful delivery of what God is saying.
Glory
to God.
Glory, glory. From glory to glory to glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Go look at what you believe in God for. Go look at it. Huh? I'm preaching good. This promise is to everybody.
Right.
This promise ain't no God. The teacher might have some pets, but God don't have them. Anybody that believe him, he'll release grace for it to be done.
Right.
What are you going to believe him for and have grace to be done for you? Glory to God. Listen, I believe God in the last month. You know what I believe him for? To be anointed to pray.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Lord, anoint me to pray. I just want to be addicted to prayer.
Hallelujah.
Lord, anoint me to pray. And now I find myself in the car riding this prayer. Glory to God. Sitting down, just praying. Walking, just praying. It just has become an addiction. An addiction to prayer. Because prayer can do anything God can do.
Yes.
let me keep going, because I got it. All right, I got to keep going. Sister Mitchell, I'm good. All right. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Sister, what you got?
Romans 4:25.
Uh-huh.
Who was delivered for our offenses?
He was delivered up for our who? Offenses.
And was raised again for our justification.
Now, if we had offenses toward God, He died for them.
Yes.
So what people still talking about? He gonna die again? You gonna die? Who gonna die? Ain't gonna be no more death. Jesus died for all of it. He was delivered up for our offenses, and he rose again for our justification. In other words, he didn't get up till we were justified. Everybody say justified.
Oh, yeah, justified.
Okay. Romans 5, 1 and 2.
Romans 5, 1 and 2. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God.
Say what?
We have peace.
We got peace with God.
Yes.
So he rose up for our justification, and through that justification, we have peace with God.
Yes.
So, everybody here thinking God mad with you about something?
You're not mad.
God ain't gonna do that for me. He mad at me. God is not like these little petty. You mad, he not.
Amen.
So don't try to put God off. He gonna slap you around. Go up there praying to God. He's gonna bust your lip. No. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We got peace with God. Brother Douglas, we got peace with God. Peace. He not mad. Oh, Father. You not mad. I just step right in there. In Jesus. In the blood. In the name of Jesus the Christ. Glory to God. He's not mad. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
By whom also we have access.
Huh?
Anybody
ever try to go on the computer and say access denied? Password expired. No access. He said we have access by faith into this grace. Huh? We got access into this grace wherein we stand and we rejoice in hope. Of the glory of God. All right, glory to God. Come on, we gotta go. We ain't spend but 2 minutes on number three. Glory to God. Who next, Brother Marvin?
Yeah.
What you got, Brother Marvin?
Much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him.
Much more. Being justified by his blood. Oh, my God. We shall be saved from wrath. Oh, and we're living in the last day. You're reading the book of Revelation. Ooh. No, ain't nobody scared about none of that. Because, glory to God, we'll be saved from wrath. Saved from wrath. And make me pure. When I rise, the world's unknown. Y'all ever heard that song? Rock of Ages. Glory to God. Okay, Sister Mitchell. Hallelujah. We coming on now.
Yeah.
I hope y'all write these scriptures down.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I am. I'm just going to read up there.
Okay.
And not only so, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have now received the atonement.
What? Yes. We have now received what?
The atonement.
And so what we doing? We rejoicing. How can somebody be quiet and then they got their atonement at one the way it was meant to be? Back with God, glory to God. Hallelujah, the flame and sword been taken away from the garden. And now we can walk back up into the garden. That garden is prepared for us. Glory to God. Okay, Brother Douglas, which one you got?
17.
You got?
17.
Okay. Amen.
Resides through the one. What was that? Through the one death.
Much more. Death came through one man, and it reigned through what? How many men?
One.
Who knows who that one man was? So all of us being sinners was based on one man.
Right.
And all of us being saved is based on one man.
Amen.
One man missed it, another man got it.
Amen.
One man gave a death. His bride led him into death. The second man went in and pulled his bride out of death into life. Thank you so much, Brother Douglas. They received the abundance of grace, and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, it's a platform of champions. Everybody in here, reign in life. Leave out that door today, reigning in life. Don't go
yes.
That life gonna just slap you around and do you like it wanna do you. Glory to God. No, I'm the beloved of God. Now you back up off of me in the name of Jesus the Christ. By the blood of Jesus, glory to God, I take my victory and I reign in life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
I'm telling y'all. 4 years ago, I came in here on four flats. It's getting better and better and better and better and better. I'm rising, glory to God. That's what I just preached on the broadcast last week. Rising, rising, reign in life. How? By one Jesus Christ. Okay. Sister Maria, which one you got? 5 and 19?
19, yeah.
Okay.
By one man's disabundance, many were made sinners.
Uh-huh.
So by the abundance of one shall many be made righteous.
Y'all get this right here?
Made righteous.
Did you get it?
Mm-hmm.
By the one, many shall be made righteous. Who is the one?
Jesus the Christ. Our Lord.
Jesus the Christ.
Jesus the Christ. You mean to tell me Jesus the Christ that made us right?
Yeah.
You see, friends, for us, glory to God, to be a successful church, we must rid ourselves of a sin consciousness. A sin consciousness is a defeat consciousness. You're always going to be with it, as long as you think God mad at you. He got a vendetta against you. You done made God, you done made him mad now. God getting tired of y'all. Glory to God. How God gonna get tired? He don't get tired. You upset. And you trying to tell me that my father is upset.
Right.
And he's not.
Right.
Because my father has been satisfied through our Lord Jesus Christ. One man,
right.
Glory to God, and his obedience made many righteous.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Okay, my brother, tell me your name again.
Jesus.
Jamion, you ready? Which word you got? I think you got 6 and 2, right? You read good, man, for third grade. Come on, give it up for him. You read good for third grade.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, man. Hallelujah. Jamion, readers are leaders. Glory to God. Ah, me the anointed. Oh, glory to God. That's what God forbid me. Me the anointed. That's how you say it in Greek. Me the anointed. Glory to God. How shall we that are dead
to sin?
How we gonna be people when we know the plan of God, keep on missing it? It ain't talking about glory to God, all this other stuff. Glory to God, all unrighteousness is sin. Anything that missed the mark from the plan of God is sin. Glory to God. Now people got sins that they think is bigger sin than other sin.
Right.
No, man, ain't nobody trying to put folks under bondage. Glory to God. I got a collar on, but but I can miss it too. Are y'all here with me? So if you hear I missed it, don't trip. Tie your shoe. Are y'all here with me? Nobody coming here with that. I got saved in 1933, and no evil have I done. You just did something and studied and told that lie in the congregation of the righteous. Are y'all here? You missed the mark. Repent. Get back on the road that you're supposed to be on. Glory to God. Admit. Somebody say it with me. Admit it.
Admit.
And quit.
And quit.
Admit it and quit. That's all you gotta do. Just admit it and quit. Don't get falling in water. Don't drown you. Is staying down in the water, that's what drown you. So what? If you fall out there today on the way out, God forbid, but if you fall and we come back next Sunday and you still laying in the same place, and we say, well, what you doing? You know I failed last Sunday. The most natural thing to do if you fall is get up. Okay, my sister, tell me your name again.
Mylia.
Now I know Mylia know how to read real good. She got good diction. I can hear. Which one you got? 6 and 7? Okay, go right ahead.
For he that is dead is freed from sin.
Ah! Yes. She did good, didn't she? Yes. All right. For he that is dead is freed from sin. You go tell the dead person anything you want. They not going to respond to you. Less like the lady, she kept telling her husband, she kept telling her husband she wanted a fur coat. I want that mink, baby. He said, as soon as I get straight now, I'm going to get it for you. Well, these people were doing their door-to-door insurance policy, and she got a real good one on him, about $250,000, and he died. So she talked to him. She said, baby, you straight now. I'm going to go get that coat tomorrow. Cool. My brother, what's your name again?
Diavion.
Okay, here comes Diavion. Which one you got? 6 and 11?
Yes.
How old are you, man? 15. He got tall for 15, ain't he? Oh, boy. Can you hoop? Huh? Can you hoop? Can you back him down? No? Okay, go right ahead.
Yes.
If you dead to this, no, let's go backwards. If you alive to this, you dead to that.
Right.
You can't do this and that. Can you? You can be pitiful or powerful, but you can't be both of them. Glory to God. Amen. All right, so give me, which one you got? 6 and 14, okay. We going pretty good. We got about 3 more, glory to God, and then we out, amen, until we come back again Wednesday. Come for prayer, man. Prayer been so good on Wednesday. Ooh, Lord, glory to God. I've been waiting to get to prayer on Wednesday. I told God that I don't mean to pray. Glory to God, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. Glory to God. Okay, what's that?
For sin shall not
have dominion over you. Uh-huh.
Or not under the law, but under
Yes.
That old nature shall not dominate you. It shall not dominate you. It shall not dominate you. Now don't lead yourself down the road, glory to God, fooling around with that old nature, glory to God, because it's dead, but you can wake it up. You post some beer in that gorilla face. When he wake up, you're going to have to feed him. Glory to God. You better have some plate ready, glory to God. But it shall not have dominion over you. You're not under the law, but under grace. Are y'all here with me?
Yes, yes.
It has to be a law in order for it to be sin. But if there is no law, there is no sin. We learn that here, and we walk in the glory to God. Brother Dixon, give me just another few minutes, y'all.
Read Romans 6 and 18.
Uh-huh.
Being then made free from sin, ye became the servants of righteousness.
Say what? Huh? Being free. Free from a life of sin, free to a new beginning. I'm free. I don't walk like I used to walk. I don't talk like I used to talk. Free from a life of sinning. Did you hear me? If you're free from this, glory to God, you a servant of righteousness. Just try. Give us 90 days. To walk in righteousness for 90 days. If it don't change, we'll give your misery, we'll refund your misery to us. Get back to you. Are you here with me? Serve righteousness. Sir, is it still out there? Yeah, them Indians still out there. I see people all the time with arrows sticking out of them. I know them Indians still out there. Are you here? You know what you do? You just pass them on by. You pass them on by. You just pass them on by. I couldn't think of what to say, Brother Baymore. I was going in Starbucks. And the little blonde pulled up in a BMW with the top rolled down. She said, "Oh, you look nice." I was dressed up on the way to church. "And wow, you smell so nice, sir. Where are you going?" I couldn't think what to say. I said, "I'm going to worship. I'm going to worship." And I got out of there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Y'all, you'd have thought that building was on fire. You got to pass it up. You got to pass it up. Because lust, when it's conceived, it brings forth sin. And sin, after it's finished, it brings forth death.
Hello.
Are y'all hearing me? The devil trying to kill you.
Yep.
How many of them know he come to but to steal, kill, and destroy? Yes, that's all he came to do. He trying to kill you. And he tell you, killing you feel good.
Yep.
Come on, I'm gonna kill you and steal from you and destroy you, and it's gonna feel good while you're doing it, while I'm killing you. All right, go ahead, Sister Monica. Free from it. Glory to God. Which one you got?
Romans 6 and 22.
6 and 22? Sure do.
But now being made free from sin and become servants to God, ye have your fruit unto holiness and the end everlasting life.
It ain't gonna just pay off in this life. It's gonna pay off in that which is to come.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say you get two checks.
Two checks.
You get one while you're here, and you get one when you get over there. Glory to God. Go right ahead, Stephen.
7 and 4. Romans 7 and 4.
Romans 7 and 4.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Didn't Monica just have 7 and 4?
No, she had 6 and 22.
6 and 22. Yeah. So you got 7 and 4.
7 and 4.
I thought she had took your scripture. No, she that's didn't. Okay.
We'd have fought.
Huh?
We'd have fought over the scripture.
Wow. I didn't hear you.
No, not him.
Never mind.
Wherefore, my brethren. ye also are become dead to the law by the body of Christ.
Dead to the law. Everybody say, I'm dead to the law.
Dead to the law.
So don't let nobody put you under no law. Rules and regulations. It's only in that new. Glory to God. You know where it come down to? Right here. Right here. In the heart. Amen. If it's in the heart, you could tell somebody all day long, don't do that. But it's in their heart. They're going to do it. Wherefore, my brother, ye also became dead to the law by the body of Christ. What?
That ye should be married to another, even to him who is raised from the dead, that ye that we should bring forth fruit unto God.
We married to who?
Christ.
Who we married to?
Our Lord and Savior, our God.
We the bride of Christ. We married to him. Are y'all hearing me? We got his name. We got his name. We have his name. Father, in the name of Jesus, we hallelujah. We give you praise. And we give you glory. And we give you honor today.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. We thank you that out of the mouth of babes and sucklers, you are ordained and praised that you might steal the enemy and the avenger. Glory to God, we are what you say we are. We have what you say we have, and we can do what you say we can do. Thank you for your mind and what you think about us. Father God, I thank you that this word won't return to you void. It will accomplish what you sent it forth to do, and it will prosper in the thing whereunto you sent it.
Glory to you, my Father. I thank you.
It will prosper in the thing whereunto you sent it. It will prosper. My sister, what grade are you in?
Six.
You're in the sixth grade. Glory to God.
She's advanced.
She's advanced.
Sixth grade, but it's like she's in high school already. So.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You continue with that. You continue with that. What is it that you want to do when you...
I'll be president.
You want to be the president. Amen.
Hello.
I'm here to tell you that you can.
You can do what you need.
I'm here to tell you I mix my faith with your faith. Glory to God. But God's going to take you through law school.
Yes.
He's going to take you through. He's going to take you through law school. And he's going to use someone to pay for it. That you're going to ride on scholarship. So you keep doing what it is that you're doing. And you keep studying the way that you study. And keep reading the way that you read. And you're going to see God's going to take you and he's going to elevate you. And you're going to have a lot. And you're going to remember you sat here in the church. And the preacher told you I was going to be a lawyer. Amen.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Give it up to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. And Brother Douglas, you know, things sometimes look like they're for one reason, but they're for another reason. But God is really dealing with you, man. And he's really drawing you to himself. He's drawing you to himself. Do you know... sometimes there are some things in your life when you say enough is enough, but you're beginning to see at this point in your life that there is more to life and the doors are opening and you're beginning to see that there's a different life that's out there for you, and God's going to give you the energy. He's going to give you the wisdom. He's going to give you the know-how, how to walk through those doors. And you're going to see God's hand moving in your life. You're going to see unusual things taking place in your life. In the next season of your life, you're going to see God turning up, and you're going to know that it's him.
You're going to know that it's him. You know what I'm saying? Nobody else can do this except God.
Right.
You know, and I see you telling people, man, you don't believe what happened to me, but this is what happened to me. God's hand and his intervention is coming forth in your life.
Amen.
And he's going to touch your family, and all of you will be a blessing to a lot of people.
Thank
a lot
you,
of people. You're going to be a blessing to them.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. So thank you so much for coming. Amen.
Amen.
I want y'all to know you're welcome. Y'all have a church?
You do now.
Yeah, we're
looking. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank God. Thank God for you. As the prophet said, y'all come go with us. We'll do you good.
Amen.
Amen. I want everybody to welcome them.
Yes.
Glory to God as they come. Right?
Amen. Yes.
Right, Damian?
Yep.
Did I say it right?
Javion.
Okay. Glory to God. Amen. Did I say it right? Okay. Glory to God. Welcome. Welcome.
Amen.
Welcome.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Just, yes, sir.
What I want to add in there, you should thank Miss Brenda.
Yeah.
Because without Miss Brenda, we wouldn't know nothing about you.
Amen.
Amen.
Wow. Amen.
You see, Miss Brenda, man, I'm telling you right now, it's something I noticed about Miss Brenda for a long time. But I had to be sure. I just had to be sure. I had to keep on watching and just be sure. She's one of the most dynamic people you could ever meet in your life. Amen. We do thank God for her and bringing her. Amen. Give it up. Amen. Because this is what we've been talking about. Bring people. Amen. Bring people to the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Bring them all to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Sister Stephanie brought Sister Yolanda. Amen. Give it up for her. Amen. Like a snowball rolling down the side of a snow-covered hill. It's growing.
I brought Stephanie. And Stephanie brought her
husband. My God, she just, oh my God, she all up in the Kool-Aid. Glory to God, amen.
Pastor, I do need to give a testimony. I do need
go
to
right ahead.
Real quick, I'm not going to even come up here. I just want to give this testimony. You know, I just praise God for from whom all blessings flow. I just praise and bless his holy name. You know, you was talking about you know, the blessings of the Lord, you know, that make it rich, that add no sorrow to them. But I was so happy that the Lord blessed me with my home. I'm just enthused about that. But you know what? I was listening and somebody on the radio, a TV, you know, TVN, and somebody was saying something about when you give, the more you give, or something like that, all kind of just blessings just be coming out of everywhere, you know what I'm saying? Yesterday, I was, you know, I had bought my home about a month ago. I mean, living in it and everything, now I'm enjoying it. And somebody came and said, you know what, I have a gift for you. And I'm thinking, well, what did I do, you know, to deserve a gift? I didn't do nothing. And then they said, well, you know, I'm going to stop back and give you a gift. So I was telling my Martin about it, you know, my son. I said, Martin, you know, he said, he's going to stop back and give you a gift. You know, I said, Mom, just go ahead on, just take the gift. You know what I mean? So anyway, Nick came back, rang her doorbell, he gave me a gift, he said, here, this is for you. I opened the gift, it was $200.
Amen.
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 And you know what, I'm just going to say, it was my realtor. And he didn't have to give me nothing, he said, I just want to thank you. He said, for Jess, you know, because I had been knowing it for a while, he helped me through a lot of things. He said, but I just want to thank you. And he said, to God be glory or something like that.
Yeah.
He said, but I just want to thank you because you said it. I just want to tell you about my lesson.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Make known in deeds among the people, glory to God. Remember, I got them $3 discount at Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Yeah.
I testified about it, glory to God. That was the favor of God saved me them $3.
Absolutely.
Are y'all breathing?
Man, I had so many clothes, I take it to the cleaners, I thought it was going to be about $400. It ended up $140. Glory to God.
I tell you, this Monday morning, me and my wife go, we usually go, we get up, we take the kids to school, and we needed the 7-Eleven to get coffee, we pissed, and we split. Well, this particular morning, we were mad at each other. So we never made it to the 7-Eleven. She had the credit card with all the money. I ain't got no money. So she got her coffee, and I ain't get to get mine. So when I get to the next 7-Eleven, she told me to download this little app they got. If I get so many coffees, you get free. Mm-hmm. But this so happened that day. I walked in there, and it was my free day.
Amen. Amen. That's it right there.
That's it.
That's it, brother. Amen. You got to believe God sometime. Glory to God. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank God for that. Brother Douglas, your entire family.